early childhood education awareness. To raise awareness of and build public support for the importance of early childhood development and health. Whereas early childhood years are when the brain grows and develops the most. In fact, 90% of a child's brain develops at age 5 before they enter kindergarten. Whereas scientific research has shown that a child's experience in their early years affect how their brain develops. Research also has proven that kids with quality early childhood experiences do better in school, are more likely to go to college and have a successful career. They also tend to be healthier and demand less from the public welfare system. Whereas the goal of Santa Cruz County School Superintendent Alfredo I. Velásquez in 2024 is to raise community awareness about the support system Santa Cruz County has for families that have children from 0 to 5 years of age. Whereas Early Childhood Education Awareness Month is sponsored by the Santa Cruz County Superintendent's Office, First Things First, Mariposa Community Health Center, University of Arizona Cooperative Extension Family Resource Centers, Nogales, Patagonia, and Rio Rico, Child and Family Resources, Inc., Child Care Resources and Referral, Nogales, Santa Cruz County Libraries, Department of Development Disabilities, Santa Cruz County Unified School District Number 1, Santa Cruz Valley Unified School District Number 35, Patagonia School District Number 6 and 20, Sonora Elementary District 25, Santa Cruz Elementary District 28, Charter Schools, Private Schools, Child Parent Centers, Inc., Nogales Challenger, Western and Rio Rico Head Start Centers, Preschools and Child Care Providers. Whereas during the month of February, informative messages will be communicated to the community via social media, radio, signage, including Santa Cruz County School Superintendent Alfredo Velásquez, promoting kindergarten preparation and the kindergarten enrollment process. Other messages will include how to identify and work with children with special needs and mental health concerns. Some activities during the month include a parent educator retreat, professional development concerning the importance of physical activity on mental health, an early childhood art exhibition, an early childhood leadership award luncheon, the Santa Cruz Regional Partnership Council of First Things First celebrates the Young Children Community Events, the University of Arizona Cooperative Extension Family Resource Centers promoting both behavioral and mental health, Mariposa Health Center promoting the importance of wellness checks, dental care, and vaccines, and American Sign Language courses at the Nogales Santa Cruz County Libraries. Now, I, Jorge Maldonado, Mayor of the City of Nogales, Arizona, do hereby proclaim February 2024 as Early Childhood Education Awareness Month.
Mayor Maldonado, Vice Mayor Jorge, City Council, Bermudez, Mr. Machado, members of the community, I want to thank you and City Council. I want to thank you for all your support. This is a very important initiative, you know, as we're moving forward and talking about workforce development and economic development, child care is a critical component of this. We need to make sure that we, in the future, look at investing in child care services for our young. We're gonna have a presentation by Mr. Young, Jennifer Gallos, we have a cooperative extension, and Francisco Padilla from First Things First. I wanna thank Ada from Mariposa County Housing and Los Padres Director, Gina Parra. I also want to say that on February 22nd, we're going to host the award ceremony. You will be receiving an invitation, and we look forward to attending. There's going to be 10 people recognized in the community, from doctors to community advocates, teachers, and students. So Without further notice, I'm gonna pass it on to Mr. Young.
Thank you for this opportunity to speak about something so important as is your child education awareness here in our community. Pretty soon, Mr. Pelia and Mr. Argoyos are going through a presentation, and they're gonna show some numbers that are pretty astounding and scary for our community when it comes to child education. I just wanted to mention one more thing. Also, we mentioned Gina and Lada, but also in the back we have the library. Denise is a huge supporter of this initiative also. And also even at Melissa Gallos in the back room. So thank you for being here. And I want to mention, Francisco may not have time to mention this, it's Saturday, there's a huge event at Calabasas School. You're all invited. It's first things first, celebrate the young child. It starts at 10 o'clock in the morning at Calabasas. There's a huge number of organizations that are going to be there with activity and everything for young children. So we invite you to attend. It's a really neat opportunity, and lunch is included. So we'll get a free lunch. So we'll start off with Mr. Padilla. Thank you very much.
Good evening, Mayor Maldonado, City Manager Ramirez, Council Members. My name again is Francisco Padilla. I'm the Regional Director here in Santa Cruz for First Things First. Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for the proclamation. We wanted to just briefly talk to you about the importance of early childhood education and what that means for not only the city of Nogales, but our entire county and our entire state. It's really hard to follow such a nice looking law. So what is early childhood education awareness month? So this is the eighth year the local organizations led by the office of Mr. Velásquez have partnered to raise awareness throughout the county on the importance of early childhood education. And what's our vision for early childhood education in Santa Cruz County? We want healthy children, we want successful students, and we want thriving communities. I don't think anybody would argue against that. Right. Usually the video here will skip. So the first 5 years of the child's life, or anyone's life, is the most important. The brain develops more rapidly than at any other time in a person's life. 90% of our brain develops by the time we turn 5. And while genetics has something to play into that, we also know through a lot of scientific research that the quality of a child's experiences, whether those are positive or negative, shapes how their brain develops. So what that means is all of these experiences that a child has before they enter into their brain, they're rich full of positive experiences, loving family, their parents speak to them every day, they take them to the park, they play, they go to preschool, high quality preschool, all of those positive experiences are going to impact how that child develops. The other side of that is that child has a lot of negative emotions.
Not every negative experiences. Let's
say they live in a unstable household. Maybe there's domestic violence. Maybe they have a parent who's incarcerated. A lot of different things, right, that could negatively impact that child. All of those negative experiences also help how that brain develops, right? And so what we want is those kids in our community to have all of those positive experiences so that by the time they enter kindergarten, they're ready to succeed. We don't want our kids to start kindergarten behind, which we see, unfortunately. So here are a couple of statistics on what our children are facing here in Santa Cruz County. One out of three of our kids, ages 0 to 5, lives in poverty, about 38%. Two out of three children eligible for preschool, so 3 and 4 year olds, don't attend preschool. And 3 out of 4 children don't receive all of the developmental screening that they need to. So why do we want to talk about early childhood? Why is this important? As I mentioned before, positive experiences in early childhood improve kindergarten readiness. So I mentioned that We want our children to start that first day of kindergarten ready to go. Unfortunately, that doesn't always happen.
Right.
But if they're ready to go that first day of kindergarten, they're going to be able to keep up with their classes.
Right.
Third grade reading scores. You know that positive early childhood experiences mean that those children have higher third grade reading scores. Anybody who is familiar with what that means for our school districts and for our kids, if a child isn't reading at third grade level by the time they exit third grade, they have a really high chance of not graduating from high school. Third grade, we can tell what that child's going to be in high school. We have higher high school graduation rates when we have positive early childhood experiences. Workforce readiness, obviously that's something that we talk about and we talk about all the time, right? We need a workforce that's ready to go. And we also know that people are healthier and have better well-beings when we have positive early childhood experiences. Excuse me. So the other side of that, what happens when we don't, when we see negative experiences? We see more children that go into special education and their remediation costs go up because they're not screened early enough, or because maybe they didn't go to preschool, they need services once they enter kindergarten, which is too late. We want them, if they have developmental delays, if they have speech delays, we want those kids to receive those services early, the earlier the better, right? We know that those folks also may become more dependent on social welfare, which is a burden on everyone as taxpayers. Crime-related costs go up because these kids aren't reading at grade level. Maybe they don't graduate high school. They can get into different things, right? Not always good things. And incarceration rates can also go up. So I'm going to have Jennifer talk about the importance of mental health.
Good evening. I think our time is safe. Skip a little bit through the mental health, make it a little shorter, but each every year for the past 8 years during our Early Childhood Awareness Month, we have chosen a different topic to shed some light on, and this year it's mental health. We know that it is imperative that our children get quality mental health before they enter kindergarten. They're not entering kindergarten without all the baggage they have from their experience from 0 to 5, and so it's important, just as important for adults and teens to get adequate mental health services as it is for the young children. Quality matters in child care and preschool. We often refer to child care or preschool as babysitting or daycare, but what we know is because our brains are developing at such a rapid rate before we ever get to preschool, the educational settings that those children are in are very, very important. There are 19 child care providers and preschool providers that are in a Quality First program, which is sponsored by First Things First. This is a quality rating system. So they go in, they look at the preschools, and they give them grades dependent on different metrics that they have for quality. We are very fortunate in Santa Cruz County to have some 5-star preschools. We also have several that are 3 or above. But unfortunately, in Santa Cruz County, we are considered a child care desert. The number of preschools that we have does not meet the number of children 0 to 5 that we have in our community. So if every child that was 3, 4, and 5 wanted to enter preschool, there would not be enough preschool slots. So some things that we have to make up for that loss is a family resource center. You've heard me before present on the family resource center. There's a family resource center right down the street. If anyone would like to visit at any time, you have a flyer with our contact information. We see about 450 families annually, and we make up for some of that loss. We teach parents to get a child's first teacher. We teach them developmental milestones and connect them to resources. We do a lot of referrals so that they can get the services they need before they get to kindergarten. We have active home visiting programs. Those Padres is here. Mariposa Community Health Center has home visitors, as well as Head Start. They go into the home, so if the families are high need and you can't get to the Family Resource Center, these programs are specifically have trained staff to work with them to kind of make sure that their homes are safe and that they're well informed about different types of parents' needs. childcare is expensive. It's not something that we want to stamp on. It is an investment in our future, in our community. And it's the number one reason this staff miss work is because they can't find childcare. And therefore, four point five times as many children were defined as there are childcare slots. So thank you so much for your time, and let us know if you have any questions.
I want to thank you again for giving us this opportunity to discuss the importance of early childhood education awareness. And I look forward to the day where city and county and our educational communities can make this a priority, and that every child in Santa Cruz County will have early childhood education. Thank you.
I thank Lefty too for all her help.
Sorry.